Hi, this is your host, Kristen Howe. I'd like to welcome you to our call with today's guest, Dr. Bradley Nelson, a holistic chiropractic physician, craniopath, and medical intuitive. Dr. Brad is also a specialist in the emerging fields of bioenergetic medicine and energy psychology. His book, The Emotion Code, is a distinct and authoritative work that is destined to become an instant classic on self-healing. It is rapidly becoming the most popular book ever written on energy psychology. Dr. Nelson has been a holistic physician in both private and virtual practice for the last 22 years. He's an international seminar presenter, medical intuitive, and gifted healer. On the call today with Dr. Bradley Nelson, you will discover how your heart can keep you from finding love. You'll find out a simple way to become a natural healer and heal your loved ones. You'll find out how trapped emotions can keep you from finding success. You'll discover the story behind the most powerful natural healing system in the world, and Dr. Brad will teach you how to release trapped emotions. So I can't wait. I'm so excited for this. Dr. Brad, thank you so much for joining us today, and welcome to the call.
Well, thank you, Kristen. It's really great to be back with you again.
I always love our time together. So what I'd love to have you do is share a little bit of you just to, you know, get everybody into the swing of who you are, how you've managed to get where you are, because what you do is pretty amazing, but it wasn't always easy. Is that a fair assessment?
Well, I'd say, oh gosh, let's see. Well, it goes back quite a few years. I started out as a chiropractor 24 years ago, and I was very, very focused on trying to help my patients get well, of course, and I was open to anything that might help them. Well, I got in the habit of asking for help from up above as I was working with people, and nobody ever knew that I was asking for help. It was just a silent thing. But actually, it was an answer to prayer, a direct answer to prayer that got me into the healing arts in the first place. And as time went on, I think that really, really made a difference, because information would filter down to me. And eventually I learned some amazing things about the body. The first thing is that the subconscious mind has all the answers. If you are sick or you're in pain, if you go to a traditional type of doctor in the West here, you'll typically be prescribed some kind of a medication to suppress that pain or to suppress those symptoms and make you feel better, which doesn't really get to the underlying root cause, as we're all realizing now. And I found that the subconscious has all those answers, and that I could ask the subconscious mind, and through a number of different methods of testing the muscles of the body, we could get those answers back. And pretty quickly, I started realizing that this was the only way to really help people. And as time went on, and as I worked with more and more people, what I found was really astonishing to me. What I found was that the single biggest underlying common denominator for all of our diseases, whether it's cancer or fibromyalgia or chronic fatigue or lupus or whatever, and the biggest common underlying denominator for all of our emotional difficulties like depression, anxiety, phobias, panic attacks, and all kinds of self-sabotage, all of it, it's the same thing. And it's all our emotional baggage. Emotional baggage. And, you know, we talk about emotional baggage, and we say things like, oh, boy, that guy's just got a lot of emotional baggage. We've probably all said that at one point or another. But, you know, the funny thing is sometimes we say things that are profoundly true without really realizing it. And that's definitely the case with that little phrase, emotional baggage. What happens to us is as we go through our lives, we sometimes hit these emotional lows where we're feeling intense negative emotions like anger or resentment or depression or whatever it is. And when we're feeling those intense emotions, the energy of that emotion can actually become lodged in the body. Now, to understand how that can happen, first of all, you have to realize that the human body is really just an energy field. I mean, you can look at your hand and it looks solid, but if you magnify that hand enough, pretty soon you're looking face to face with a single individual atom. And if you could look inside that atom, you'd see there's really nothing in there. It's just empty space and some little infinitesimally tiny energies that are zipping around at the speed of light. And that is really ultimately what you are. We're beings of pure energy. And it's really time we let that sink in. You know, the quantum physicists have been telling us that now for over 100 years, but it's time that we're realizing that that is really what we are. So energy medicine or healing with energy then becomes a natural alternative. It becomes a very natural thing and easy to understand and easy to accept. Well, so what are emotions? Well, we know that thoughts can be measured electronically, right? And emotions also can be measured, and it seems that each individual emotion has its own individual frequency. So anger is a different vibrational frequency than an emotion of depression, and that's different from frustration. And they're all different. And so when you're feeling an intense emotion, what you're really feeling is a specific vibrational energy or frequency. And so sometimes what happens to us is that these emotions that we experience are so powerful and so intense that the energy of the emotion can't be processed by the body in some way. And when that happens, the energy of the emotion, part of that emotional energy, becomes lodged or stuck in the body, and it stays with us years, decades after that event is over, and often it's forgotten. Yet that energy stays with us, and it can create all kinds of problems for us. An example that comes to mind is actually, there are lots of these, but one of the examples that I quote in the book is a lady who came to me. She was, I think, about 71 years old, and it was her very first visit. And as I asked her subconscious mind and did some muscle testing to get some answers, I found out that she had a trapped emotion of sadness. And so it's a very simple process that anybody can learn. We have kids doing this, but I traced this back to see when this had occurred, and it actually went back 10, 20, 30, 40 years. It went back to 1963, and that's what her subconscious mind said, that that's when that had occurred. And I thought to myself, well, gee, maybe that was about JFK's assassination that happened in November of that year. And so I verbalized that to her, and at the same moment that I'm getting a strong answer back from her arm saying, her subconscious mind, in other words, saying, yes, that's exactly what created this emotion that is trapped inside of me. At that same moment, she's breaking down, crying and saying, oh yeah, that affected me so deeply. When his son died in the plane crash, JFK Jr., all I could do for days was cry. I couldn't even work or do anything. And so then I wanted to know, okay, she has this trapped emotion. Her subconscious mind wants to get rid of this. Where has this energy been all these years? Now, a trapped emotion, the fascinating thing about this, you see, is that emotions are things. They're things. A trapped emotion is actually a ball of energy in the body that typically is about the size of a baseball to the size of a cantaloupe, and it will lodge somewhere in the body. Now, we all have these. Whoa. But in her case, I wanted to know, okay, where has this been, this energy of sadness, where has this been all of her life? What's it been doing to her? Because these have an effect on us. And so asking questions, we figured out it wasn't on the right side of her body. It was lodged somewhere on the left side of the body, and it turned out that it was lodged right in the front of her chest area where the left breast was. That breast had been removed 4 years before, see, because it became malignant, see. So what I have found is that every case of cancer that I saw during the last 24 years of practice in one form or another, there are always trapped emotions there. Every single disease process that I have seen, and I've seen all kinds, and I treated people from all over the U.S. and Canada in my own practice, every single disease process had trapped emotions that were part of that underlying constellation of reasons why that person was having symptoms. So you see how important it can be to find these and get rid of these. And you see, we have a tendency to think that when we go through some intense emotional event and it was yesterday and we're not feeling that same exact feeling now, that it's gone and it's passed. But, you know, oftentimes nothing could be further from the truth. These energies can stay with us and can affect us in just remarkable ways. I got an email just a few days ago from a lady who said that she had some trapped emotions removed. And for the first time in 31 years, she slept through the night suddenly. You know, I mean, yeah, we have testimonials coming in from people literally all over the world. I can't even keep track of them anymore, that are telling us all kinds of amazing things like this. Now, the beauty of the emotion code is that it really is designed to empower the individual, you see. This work is so simple that anyone can do this. In fact, Kristen, I have to tell you a really interesting story. I met a woman recently who told me about something that happened to her. She purchased the Emotion Code book and the book on audio, and she started listening to it and reading it. And her son noticed what she was doing, and he started listening as well and reading the book. And then when he finished, he started practicing with his friends and releasing their trapped emotions. And a couple of weeks later, the phone rang. And there was a woman on the other end of the line, and she identified herself as the mother of one of her son's playmates, friends. And she said, my son has had a phobia of water all of his life, and we've tried all kinds of things to fix it, and nothing has ever worked. And she said, right now, my son is swimming in the pool. She said, your son did this. She said, I don't know what your son is doing, but you've got to fill me in on what is happening here and how this is even possible. So see, those two boys are 11 years old. Think about that.
Wow.
That's how easy this is, you see.
I love that. Okay. So tell me this. So now we know what trapped emotions are. And by the way, I couldn't help myself from going, wow, when you said how big, and that's amazing.
Yeah.
The size. that's incredible. How can these trapped emotions, how are they keeping us from finding success, love, anything else that we're, you know, looking to manifest in our lives?
Well, you know, what these trapped emotions do is they deflect us from the course that we would often like to follow. They push us in directions that we might not want to go. They cause us to misinterpret innocent remarks, and they cause us to feel emotional responses that we otherwise would not feel. Now, they interfere with our ability to succeed and to find love, when, especially when they form what we call a heart wall, that is a wall of energy that surrounds the heart. And the discovery of the heart wall has been called the most important discovery in the history of energy medicine. And I didn't discover it. It was actually shown to me. It was one of the most remarkable experiences of my whole life. And what happened was a number of years ago, my wife she woke me up one morning and told me that she'd had a dream. And in her dream, she saw three symbols. And she knew when she woke up that these three symbols had to do with her health and well-being. And they were issues we hadn't dealt with before. And as I was helping her trying to figure out what these symbols meant, I suddenly had what I can only describe as a waking vision, where suddenly before me, I am seeing this beautiful hardwood floor. We were in a hotel room, actually. I was supposed to be speaking at this conference on magnetic healing up in Portland, Oregon, when this happened. And suddenly there's this incredibly beautiful floor in front of me. It was a very strange thing. And this lasted for several minutes. And at the same time that I'm seeing this beautiful hardwood floor, in fact, this was so vivid. It was the most beautiful floor I've ever seen in my life. It looked at it like it had 100 coats of polish. It was really just amazing. But at the same moment that I see this floor, this understanding comes into my mind that my wife's heart is underneath this floor. And I had absolutely, I mean, you can imagine, if this happened to you, you'd have no idea what was going on.
Yeah.
And I had no idea what this meant, but it was very clear. Obviously, there was a huge message being sent to me. I didn't know what it meant. I told my wife what I was seeing and understanding, and she didn't know either, but we prayed for some help, and we started doing some testing and asking her subconscious mind questions, and here's what we figured out. She was born into a very volatile family. Her father was a rageaholic and very dysfunctional, lots of anger and contention all the time. And when she was around 2 years old, she had felt that feeling that we call heartache or heartbreak enough that her subconscious mind decided that she needed to put up a wall around her heart, or her heart was going to be totally broken. Now, those feelings, that the physical sensation that we have when we're really hurt or we're really grieved or someone's really being mean to us, that's a physical thing. And that's where those words heartache and heartbreak come from, because you feel like there's an elephant sitting on your chest, or you feel like you're choking, like you can't breathe. And most of us have felt that at one point or another. Well, the research now is actually aligning with the ancient understandings of what the heart really is. You see, ancient peoples understood the heart to be the seat of the soul and the source of our love and the source of our creativity. And we in the West have had a tendency to believe that those ancient peoples were just silly. They didn't have the technology that we have today. And, you know, it was all just poetic license. But guess what? Now the technology that we have that's very advanced is starting to show us that, yes, they were actually right. The heart puts out a magnetic field that is about 12 feet in diameter now, we find, now that we can measure the heart with a new device called a magnetocardiogram. And they've proven in the laboratory now several times that if one person is feeling love or affection and focusing that love or affection on another person, that their heartbeat will appear in the brain waves of that person that they're focusing that love or attention or affection on. Isn't that amazing? Think about that.
Wow.
Yeah. So you see, there's a communication going on between all of us all the time, and it's really from the heart. Well, the problem is we go through these periods of our lives where we feel like our heart is going to break. And that is really an assault on this deepest part of us, on the deepest core of our being. And so when that happens more than a couple of times, your subconscious mind will start to build a wall to protect your heart from being totally broken. And that's what happened to my wife. Well, she'd had this heart wall since age 2. The price that she paid was that she felt isolated a lot. She, even with friends that she'd known for years, she still really never quite felt like she belonged. Like, she always felt like she was a little bit of an outsider and a little bit expendable. And it was easy for her to feel negative emotions, but hard to feel positive ones. And she struggled with depression and anxiety and so on. Well, we started releasing those emotions that were making up that wall. Now, think about this. This is really interesting. The heart wall is made of layers of trapped negative emotions. Okay. So one layer might be anger and another layer might be sorrow and so on. Well, it took a couple of weeks and finally all those layers were taken off and that heart was suddenly open again and there was no wall around it anymore. And what happened with her was that suddenly she felt like she belonged, really for the first time in her life, with people that even that she'd known for a long time. She had this change that came over her. And at first I thought that maybe she was the only person on the planet who has this phenomenon going on, because she said some interesting things. I've learned a lot from her, actually, probably why I married her. But anyway, now we know that about 93% of people actually have this phenomenon going on in their lives. And so, you know, the profound thing about this is that when that heart wall is taken down, there are changes that happen to people that are so amazing and that are really not able to be explained in any kind of Western medical understanding. I mean, now listen to this. I'm telling you, when people have that heart wall taken down, if they were not able to find a mate or they were lonely, that often changes. In fact, I was talking with a woman recently who said that her sister had been divorced for about 9 years. She wanted to get remarried. She wanted to have a relationship, but she just didn't know what to do, didn't know how to do it. And nobody ever called her and so on. Well, she worked on her. She cleared her heart wall. And she told me that the following week, the phone started to ring. Guys started calling her and asking her out. It's amazing. It sounds fanciful. It sounds made up, but I'm telling you, I am not making this up. I was talking with one of our practitioners recently who told me that in January, among her other clients, she took on 3 new clients who were all single women. They all wanted to be in a relationship, but none of them were. Turned out they all happened to have a heart wall. Again, 93% of us have this wall. She was able to take down those heart walls, remove those emotions from those 3 women in fairly short order. And by Valentine's Day, February 14th, all 3 of them were in love. Think about that.
Wow.
Yeah. So that's how powerful this work is. I mean, it's not only about falling in love, but it's also about unlocking that creative genius, really, that is locked up inside of your heart. Now, I want you to think about somebody. Think about Steve Jobs and think about all that he was able to do. And unfortunately, he died young, but think about all that he was able to do and really transform the world. He spoke at Stanford in 2004, and what he said was to these students, he said, you've got to follow your heart. He said, somehow your heart already knows what your best creation is, and you've got to follow your heart and follow your intuition. Well, what if you have a heart wall? See, I think that Steve Jobs was one of the 7%ers, I call them, the people that don't have that wall around their heart. But for the rest of us, what do we do? Well, that heart wall will definitely interfere in very dramatic ways with your ability to create abundance and to create money and to create whatever it is that you want to create. You see, I think that everybody has a perfect creation locked up inside their own heart, but the experiences that we've been through in our lives oftentimes build this wall around us, and then we're really handicapped.
Yeah, that makes complete sense. So, and you're saying, I mean, I love you telling the story about the, your son being 11, was it?
Oh, it wasn't my son. It was just the son of
I'm sorry, that's
that,
what I meant.
The yeah,
son, yeah, the 11. Woman in the 11. I mean, that's incredible. So what are some, you know, what are some of the things that we can do? Because I know you said it's that simple, to become a natural healer and start helping ourselves and our loved ones.
Well, you know, the easiest thing to do is to just get a hold of the emotion code. The best thing to do is just actually start studying it. And it's really, I think, the most fascinating information that you can find. It's really fun. Most people just devour the book. I mean, you'd be amazed how many times I see that word devour. People email me and they say, I devoured your book. And it's really funny. But it's fun reading and it's true. You see, it has the added benefit of being true. And so it actually does work. That's my recommendation, is to just start using it and practicing it on yourself and on your friends. And it's amazing how powerful it can be. I got an email recently from a woman in Mexico who worked on herself. She cleared her own heart wall. She told me that she had started having one creative idea after the other when her heart wall was taken down, and that the old energy that she used to have, which had been gone for a long time, was suddenly back with this tremendous force. And that's just typical. It's really just so typical. But if you think about it, I mean, I believe now that 90% of the pain that we deal with is actually due to our emotional baggage. I mean, this is huge. And the cat is really out of the bag now. This is all over the world already. And people are understanding that for the first time, what our emotions do to us and how they affect us years and decades down the road, see? So it's important to get rid of your emotional baggage. And if you're trying to find love, or if you're trying to find success, you've got to check and see if you've got a heart wall. Now, if you'd like, I can maybe show people how to do the sway test.
I was just going to say, you just took the words out of my mouth. Yes,
oh, really?
Please do that.
Okay, great. Well, this is a really easy method. It's the simplest method that we teach as far as how to get information from the subconscious mind. So I was saying a little while ago that the subconscious mind is where all the information is. If you think about it, the conscious mind is where you live. It's where you spend all your waking time. And you think it's pretty smart, but, you know, when's the last time you lost your car in a parking lot? For me, it was about a week ago. And you can't remember what you had for dinner yesterday, probably, or maybe a few days ago. The conscious mind doesn't know much, but the subconscious mind remembers everything. It's an archiving holographic computer that is keeping track of everything that you've ever done, every face you've ever seen in a crowd. I mean, the whole history of your health or disease, it's all in there. And whether you have any emotions trapped in your body, that's all in there as well. So here's how we do the sway test. First of all, if you think about a plant, think about a potted plant. If you take that potted plant and you put it near a window and you come back a few months later, or maybe a few weeks later, you'll notice that the plant is growing towards the light coming in from the window. And that's natural. Did you know, though, that if you put a plant in front of a speaker, and that speaker is playing beautiful, soothing lullabies or classical music, the plant will actually grow towards, it'll bend itself towards the music coming out of that speaker. Now, on the other hand, if you put on some real harsh, maybe like acid rock type music and turn up the volume, the plant will actually grow away from the speaker, and the roots themselves will bend away from that noise coming out of the speaker. This is a fascinating thing. It's been proven in the lab. Well, the human body is an organism that also is capable, of course, of responding to positive or negative input, just like a plant. And so here's how we do this. We call this the sway test. Your body will tend to sway forward toward thoughts of truth or positivity or congruency, and it will tend to sway backward away from thoughts of falsehood or negativity or incongruency. So here's how this works. First of all, you can do this either standing or sitting. If you have the option, it's a little easier, I think, to do it standing. But if you don't have the option, you can sit. Just make sure that the back of your chair is not touching your back. And so if you're standing, here's what you do. You drop your hands down by your sides, and you totally relax. You close your eyes. And think about this word. We're going to start with something negative, okay? And then we'll finish on something positive. So think about this word. The word is war. Now, we hear that word every single day if we watch the news or read the papers at all. But what I'd like you to do is think about that word for a moment and imagine what really goes on for a moment in war. Imagine if you had to explain what happens in war to somebody that didn't know what it meant, what that word entailed, or what it was about, what would you say? So as you think about that word war, as you're standing there very relaxed or sitting very relaxed, the moment that you get into resonance, the moment that you make a connection with what that word really means, at that same moment, your body will start to sway backwards. And that's your subconscious mind trying to help you to get away from the negativity of that thought, kind of like the plant growing away from the negative music coming out of the speaker. Same thing. All right. Now, let's try something positive. Are you doing this along with?
Of course.
Okay. Did that work for you?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay.
All right. So let's try something positive now. This usually works for just about everybody. But here's what you want to do now. Again, just stand there totally relaxed, arms down by your sides, eyes closed, and think about this word. Think about the word gratitude. And can you think of anyone in your life that you really are grateful for? Has someone ever really done something really nice for you? Or is there someone who just loved you so much that you will always remember them? Maybe it was a teacher when you were a kid, or maybe it was a parent, or maybe it's your spouse or a child. But if you think about your feeling of gratitude, especially for that person or that event or whatever it is, as you feel that feeling and allow your heart to fill with that feeling of gratitude, what happens? Boom, you start to sway forward. The moment you start to connect with what that word gratitude really means, the moment you start to feel that word, you'll start to sway forward. And I know that a lot of your listeners were right on their tiptoes on that one. And
yeah,
probably a lot of people were rocked back on their heels by the thought of war too, see? So what this is, you see, it's basically what we're doing is we're allowing the subconscious mind to actually speak to us. See, the subconscious mind is kind of like a computer that's in a black box inside of your body. And we don't normally have ways to access it. And this is a very clear, simple way to access it. So now I'd like you to think about something else. I'd like you to just make this statement, okay? I have a trapped emotion. Now, if that's a true statement, you should sway forward on that statement. If it's not true, you'll sway backwards. So try that. Just think about that statement. I have a trapped emotion. I have a trapped emotion. And the moment you connect with that thought and the energy of that thought, because every thought is really just an energy, the moment that you connect with that, your body will start to sway forward or backward. Now let's ask another one, okay? Ask this question. Do I have a heart wall? Ask that question. Do I have a heart wall? And if the answer is yes, you'll go forward. And if it's not, you'll go back for no. Try that. Do I have a heart wall? Do I have a heart wall? And again, when you connect with that, you'll go one way or the other, okay? And so this method, the sway test, can be used to track down these trapped emotions and to release them. And so it's really just a simple matter of asking questions. And once people get this down, it's simple enough and quick enough that most people can identify a trapped emotion and release it within about a minute or so, sometimes 2 minutes, but oftentimes just 1 minute, which isn't very long. And that's the reason why the emotion code is becoming so very, very popular with so many doctors and massage therapists and psychologists and psychiatrists and on and on and on all over the world, because it doesn't take any time. It's super fast and super efficient, way faster and way more efficient than any other method of energy psychology that we have ever seen up until now. And I'd love to take credit for this because it's so great, but actually it came down to me from up above. And so I just tell people, look, I just work here. That's basically the sway test and how that works.
Yeah, I love that. And it is. Within seconds, I was like, oh, I have a trapped emotion and I have a heart wall. Boom.
Okay.
so fast. Is that something, can you guide us through maybe releasing some of our trapped emotions?
Yeah, let's do this. How about if I demo it on you and I'll kind of explain the process, because in order to do it, you actually have to have the chart of emotions. And
okay,
I have a chart right here. If you'd like, we can go ahead and release an emotion from your heart wall.
Sure. That would be
okay.
Great.
All right. Awesome. So here's how this works. First of all, in the book and in the videos and so on, we teach how you can do this at a distance. And we call this working by proxy. The human body has this amazing ability built right into it to set aside its own needs to act on behalf of someone else. Now, we've had this built into us all along, and we never knew it until now, but it works really, really well. So here we go. The first thing that I like to do before I work on someone, and what I also recommend for people, is that you take a moment and make a connection with the higher power, okay? So I like to just offer a short, silent prayer for help, because really, I believe that the highest duty of the healer is to act as go-between for that higher power. So give me just a second here.
Okay,
Kristen, let's see if we've got a good connection here with you. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to be muscle testing myself, and we teach a number of different methods of doing this, but once you learn how to do it, it's actually really simple. So let's ask this question. Can I act as proxy for you? And the answer there is yes. Now, I'm getting a strong muscle response. That means yes. Weak muscle response means no. So here we go. All right, I have a chart in front of me. It has 60 emotions in this chart, and it's divided into two columns and six rows. Now, your subconscious mind knows all about all your emotions, and it knows how many you have, et cetera. So what we're going to do is ask about your heart wall and see if we can remove a trapped emotion from your heart wall. So do you have a heart wall? And I'm getting a yes. And can we release a trapped emotion from your heart wall right now? And the answer there is yes. Okay, so what is this emotion? Is it listed here in our chart in column A? And I'm getting a no answer on that. So that means it's over in column B. So we just got rid of half the chart. We just got rid of 30 emotions. We have 30 left. But watch us do that again. Ready? Here we go. Is this trapped emotion in one of the odd rows? We've got rows 1, 3, and 5, or it could be in even rows 2, 4, or 6. But is it in one of the odd rows in column B? And the answer is no. So that means it's got to be in row 2, 4, or 6. We've got it down to 15 emotions now. Let's ask, is it in row 2? And the answer is no. So we have 10 emotions left. Is it in row 4? And the answer is yes. So we now have 5 emotions left, and it's got to be depression, frustration, indecisiveness, panic, or taken for granted, one of those. And you might think you know which one it is, but you may be totally wrong because it might have been from years ago. Who knows, right? So
right.
Let's see. So is this trapped emotion depression? No. Is it frustration? No. Is it indecisiveness? No. Is it panic? No. Is it taken for granted? No, actually, it's showing up that it's not any of those. Now, this is typically how we find emotions that have been inherited from an ancestor. So what that means is at the moment of conception, you got one of these emotions from either your mom or dad. Let's find out where this came from. Is this an inherited emotion? And the answer is yes. Okay, did you get this from your father? Nope, came from your mother. Is it depression? No. So is it inherited frustration or indecisiveness or panic? It's actually panic. It's an inherited emotion of panic that you got from your mother. And did she get this from anybody earlier? Yes, she did. Did she get it from her mother? No, from her father. Okay. So did he get this from anybody earlier? No. Okay. So this came from your grandfather, your mother's father. Okay. So what that means is, you see, when your mother was conceived, your grandfather passed some emotional energy to her. And then when you were conceived, your mother passed it to you. And now, do you have any children?
No.
No. Okay. All right. So that's fine. Let's go ahead and ask, do we need to know more about this trapped emotion? And the answer there is no. Okay. So to release a trapped emotion like this, what we do is we can use a magnet or we can use fingertips. We've tried all kinds of magnets. You can even use a refrigerator magnet, believe it or not, to do this. The refrigerator magnet may actually be the most powerful healing device in your whole house.
Absolutely.
It's funny to think about.
I love that.
But anyway, I'm using a magnet right now, and I'm going from my forehead. I'm passing that magnet over the top of my head to the back of my neck, and I'm doing that 10 times. Now, what I'm doing, it actually is very scientific. There's a meridian. It's called the governing meridian. It travels from the upper lip over the top of the head and down the back, all the way down to the tailbone. And what we have found is that we can put energy into that meridian, and it actually will release the trapped emotion. Now, normally it just takes 3 swipes for a trapped emotion, but what we found is that when the emotion is inherited, the subconscious mind likes us to do 10 swipes of a magnet. So there we go. I've just done 10, and let's ask if we have released that inherited emotion of panic from you that you got from your mom, that she got from her dad, and the answer is yes. Okay. Did it also release from your mother? Yes, it did. And did it also release from her father? And the answer there is yes. So are they, your grandfather, is he living or?
No.
Okay. How about your mom?
Yes.
Okay.
And
all
panic
right.
makes complete sense.
Okay. Yeah, oftentimes these do make complete sense.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. So now let's ask, do you still have a heart wall? And the answer is yes. Is your heart wall, now the heart wall will always have some kind of a thickness to it. There will always be some kind of a symbolic material that's chosen for it, like, you know, bricks or stone. Or in my wife's case, it was hardwood. She grew up in a house with hardwood floors. And when the subconscious mind wants to create a wall, I think that it kind of, the subconscious innately knows that walls in our world are literally made of energy. I mean, if you think about it, you know, you can look at a wall in your house and you could say it's made of wall board and all kinds of things like that. But really, ultimately, it's made of atoms and energy. And so when the subconscious needs to put up a wall around the heart, it grabs these emotional energies that are in the body and it moves them and it creates a wall with them. Does that kind of make sense?
Yes.
Okay. So that's how it works. So we release that emotion from you, that panic emotion. So what kind of an effect would that have had maybe in your life? Well, let me tell you a story. I asked my daughter one day about 3 years ago to work on me, and she was up in Seattle and I was here. I live a couple of hours north of Las Vegas. And so she was working on me, and as she's working on me by proxy, she suddenly found out that I had this inherited emotion. And the emotion that I had was hopelessness. And she started to trace it back. And I had gotten it from my father, who got it from his mother, who got it from her mother. And it went back 22 generations.
Wow.
Now, back to some grandmother of ours in Ireland, we think. And when my daughter arrived at that person, that's where this had started and where it came from, suddenly she could feel the presence of that grandmother standing right next to her, not in any kind of a spooky sort of way, not like a ghost or anything or being haunted, but she could just feel it. She was there and she could feel her emotions. She could feel how desperate she was to have this emotional baggage released from her posterity. That's what she had passed on.
Wow.
Generation upon generation. And we have no way of knowing what she went through in her life. And it was probably awful. I mean, we probably back in the 1500s, I mean, we just don't know, but she could also feel how overwhelmed with gratitude she was, that this was being released, you see. And when my daughter released it, she could feel it released not only from that grandmother, but also from all those other generations all the way back. Now, on my end, I'm sitting at home, and I know that she's working on me, and suddenly I know the moment that she released that, and I knew exactly what it was, because I had struggled with this emotion of hopelessness all my life, really, and it was always kind of something that I just struggled with. And when I wrote the Emotion Code book, it took me longer than it should have, because it took me years longer than it should have, because I felt that emotion about it, like it was hopeless that I couldn't do it. And whenever I would write it, I'd have to psych myself up for half an hour to an hour to be able to write. And suddenly that background music of hopelessness, it's hard to describe, but suddenly it was gone. And that was the first time in my life that I actually knew that it was really even there, that I recognized it. It was really quite amazing. You know, if you live next to a factory that's running 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and there's noise coming out of it, after a while, you don't even notice it anymore. You know,
right.
You tune it out. That's what happened with me. The silence was deafening for me when that emotion was released. And so in your case, you see, this emotion of panic probably has tended in your life to make you more prone to anxiety or to panic when things don't go right. And getting this released may just make a really huge difference for you. It's a beautiful thing to release these emotions, because what happens is we end up, it's almost like we step out of this old skin that we've gathered on, you know, to ourselves, and we're able to step out of that and become the beings that God really intended us to become. And that's really what it's about. So
yeah,
well, what
no,
could
that's
be better than
amazing.
That?
Amazing. Exactly. What could be better? Okay, now I have to ask you this, because it's something I happen to be very passionate about, and I know so many people listening are as well. Who doesn't love, you know, anybody that has animals, they love their animals. Okay. Does this work on animals?
This absolutely works It's incredible how well this works with animals. And in fact, there's a whole chapter in the Emotion Code book about animals. I never suspected that animals might have trapped emotions, but I found out because I was called on fairly often to go down and work on animals just as a chiropractor. And then I suddenly found out that, yes, they have emotions, and the emotions become trapped. And trapped emotions, just like people, are responsible for 90% of all their problems, whether they're behavioral right. or physical. I have to tell you one animal story because this is right. such a neat one. What happened was I got a call to work on a horse one day. So I went down to the stable, and people had heard that I was coming. So there was a little crowd kind of gathered around there to see the, you know, the crazy doctor, right? So this horse, it had a problem with its hindquarters, and it wasn't walking right. And they'd had a couple of vets look at it, and they couldn't quite figure out what was wrong. And so that's usually when they would call me. So I went down to look at it and tested it and found that it had a trapped emotion. And the trapped emotion was sadness. And so when you're working with an animal, usually what you do is you can have another person that you muscle test through, but you actually ask the animal the questions, and then the answers will manifest on the on what we call the surrogate person. And that's what I was doing that day, and it actually works incredibly well. So I'm talking to the horse, basically, and I'm asking, okay, well, this sadness, was this about another horse? No. The answer came back. Was it about a person? No. Was it about a dog? No. Cat? No. I'm running out of options, and a bird flies overhead. And so I asked, was it about a bird? And the answer came back very strong. Yes, it was about a bird. And I started laughing. And all the people gathered around, they were all laughing as well, because it just seemed so comical that a horse could have sadness about a bird. But the owner of the horse was there, and she said, wait a minute. She said, I think I know what this is about. A week before, there was a baby bird that fell out of its nest right in front of this horse's stall, and it struggled for its life on the ground and eventually died. Now, the horse was in its stall during this whole sad episode, and it was powerless to do anything to help, and it was overcome with this emotion of sadness. Think about that. And that emotion was so powerful for the horse that it became trapped in the horse's body. And then by releasing that emotion, which again just took seconds, horses like it when you start between their ears and you go all the way down to the tail with a magnet or your fingertips, cleared that emotion and took the horse out. And of course, the lameness was instantly gone. And that's typically how it is with animals. Let me tell you one more animal story, because these are so fun and they're so moving. One of my practitioners wrote to me recently, and she said that she was asked to go and work on this little dog. I think it was a Lhasa Apso or a little dog like that. And what had happened was about a year before, this dog had run into the house and was really excited to see its owner and so on. But the floor had been waxed and it was very slippery, and the dog couldn't get its footing, and it slid into something sharp and got hurt. And so for the next year, that dog would not set foot in the house. They had to feed it outside. They tried everything to coax that dog to come back in, and there was no way. And so this practitioner went over, she checked the dog, she worked on the dog, she found a trapped emotion of terror or something like that, and cleared it from the dog, and the dog got up and walked right in. And, you know, there's no placebo effect with animals, you see, and that's right. That's one of the exciting things about it. And there's so many animal stories. There's a lot of them in the book.
Well, I think that's why it is so incredible, is because you're like, well, they don't know, so they're not going to be like, oh, sure, that worked. That's what's so incredible. Now, is the technique different for animals, or is it the same?
No, that's the beauty of it. I tell people that when you learn how to do the emotion code for people, well, you've kind of become a people whisperer, and when you learn how to do it for animals, well, you're an animal whisperer, because 90% of all their problems are actually just due to trapped emotions. And we have people who are working with vets, for example, who release these trapped emotions. And even if you're just using it for your own pet, I mean, it can be just so profound and such a wonderful thing. And there's so many times animals have issues because maybe they've been hurt, or maybe we see it a lot with horses, where horses are sent off for some kind of training and they end up being kind of brutalized, and then they come back and they're not the same horse anymore. Well, you can fix your animals, you can fix your horses. And it's exactly the same process. There's no difference at all. We use the same exact list of emotions, and animals can even have a heart wall that happens. So it's the same thing. There's no difference at all. And that's the beauty of it. It's so simple. I'm a big, big fan of simplicity. And one of my favorite quotes is from Einstein, who said, things should be made as simple as possible, but no simpler.
That's great. I love that. That's perfect.
He had a great sense of humor.
So what I would love to have you share, you just shared some very cool animal success stories. Can you share a few of the, you know, transformations that you've seen with people that have applied what you're teaching here?
Oh, absolutely. Well, you know, one of the most exciting things that we have going on is that we have a certification program that's available. Now, let me tell you something. You can easily spend $10,000 plus to become an energy healer and to get some kind of certificate, and it might take you several years. You can become certified in the emotion code for less than $500, and you can do it in just a couple of months because it's so simple. We allow you 6 months, but people hardly ever take that long. But the beauty of that is that then you can actually create your own clientele. And that's, I think, to me, that's the most exciting thing that's happening right now for people, because think about it. The world that we're living in is becoming more and more unstable. But if you become certified in the emotion code, you can actually have a business that you run from your laptop, and you can have your clientele that can be all over the world. And they will pay you in advance for the work that you're doing. And believe me, there's no shortage. There's no shortage of trapped emotions in the world. We're going to need more and more practitioners as this becomes more and more widely known around the world. But the beauty of having a business like that is that you're just on, you know, all you need is a web connection and a laptop, and you could literally be anywhere in the world. And that's what my daughter actually does. She travels. She's in Scotland now. She's moving to France soon, and she has her clientele that she works with, and they're all over the world. And we have a lot of people doing that. We've got over 700 practitioners now worldwide. We'll be doubling that really soon here within probably the next couple of months. So,
wow, very cool. So, and it pretty much, you know, because you and I both agree on this, blocked emotions can cause you to experience lack in any area of your life, correct? This isn't just a, like, I'll feel better. This is truly, like, what you see in your life can very much, or what you don't see, it's a good way of putting it, very well might be caused because of blocked emotions or a heart wall, correct?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely right. You know, it's such an important thing for us to do that, you know, releasing these trapped emotions, it's like emotional hygiene. It's clearing our bodies from all of this junk that we've picked up. The beauty of it is that the emotion code makes it so fast and so simple that it doesn't really take much time. Now, you might have quite a few trapped emotions in your body, but still, it's a process that you can do yourself, just a little bit, take a little bit of time each day. And then before too long, things will be cleared out, and you will be amazed how it changes you and how the peace that you've been seeking all your life can actually come to you, and how the changes that take place as far as people's emotional baggage, getting rid of it, can be so profound. I've seen people suicidally depressed get well literally in a matter of days. And I mean, that's as young as 9 years old. Okay. There's no age limit to this. Children can have a heart wall. Children have trapped emotions. Children can be born with trapped emotions that they've inherited. You were born with that panic emotion. That you came out of the womb with that one. And we all have this emotional baggage. But, you know, we're living in a time of tremendous transformation. And how are we going to transform this world? How are we actually going to do that? It has to happen. And it's going to happen. It's inevitable. This work, I believe, is part of that, you see. And I'm just very grateful. And it's a very humbling thing to actually be the instrument to bring this into the world. But, you know, I've really wanted all my life to be an instrument in the hands of God to do something. And he's honored that, that desire of mine by allowing me to do this work and bring this work into the world. And like I said, I don't take any credit for it. I just happen to be there and be in the right place at the right time. But I really hope that you'll take the time to actually look at this, because it has been such an invaluable thing for my wife and I. If I only look at our own marriage and at raising our own children, it's been just priceless for that. And if that's all you do with it, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
That's great.
And you'll be changing your life. Yeah. So what I want to do, because I know I get so excited about this because I do so believe in, you know, there really are no limitations. And so blocked emotions, and even with the inherited emotions thing, like for me, that's so powerful. And how many of us are walking around with these emotions that we can't, you know, I kind of always felt like I didn't own that, but it was still there.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So, you know, so that's so powerful too. So you did put together a special offer for everybody who's listening. So what I want to do is, everyone, I encourage you, simply click on the special offer button that is on this page, and it will take you right there. And Dr. Brad, take it away. Let us know what we'll find there.
Okay, fantastic. Well, you know, I've been all over the world teaching the Emotion Code Seminar, and I get emails from people from all kinds of different places in the world saying, we want you to come here and we want you to come there. And I can't really be everywhere. So what we did is we recorded one of the best seminars that we have done, actually. We recorded that seminar, and we have that now as part of this transformation package. The beauty of this is a 6-DVD high-definition set. And what you can do is you can sit at home, you can plug these DVDs in, and you can actually attend the seminar live. It's almost like you're there. You can see me teach all of this, teach all these different methods of muscle testing. You can see me bring people out of the audience that have different kinds of problems and see how we work with those. You get to practice right along with the audience. And by the time this is over, you've been trained in the Emotion Code. It's really wonderful. Well, that set on our website sells for $297. Okay, this is the same price as our seminar ticket. Now, the Chart of Emotions Magnet is another thing that we ship to you. So these two things we ship to you. The Chart of Emotions Magnet is a high-quality 3x5-inch magnet, and it contains the entire Emotion Code Chart of Emotions. And that allows you to not only find the emotion, but also to you can use the magnet to release the emotion. So it's really, really handy. Just don't put it next to your credit cards. That's all. All right. So we ship those things to you right away. You also get the Emotion Code ebook, which is the same book in full and complete form that we have translated into all these different languages now, and it's changing the world. And we also include for you, that's a $17.97 value, but we also include the audio book. So this is the recording of the book. It's me reading the book to you, and that's a $47 value. And those two things, the ebook and the audio book, the audio book is MP3 download. So you can actually record those onto CDs, or you can put them on your iPod or iPad or iPhone or whatever and listen to those. And it's a great companion volume. Now, this whole package, if you were to buy all these items separately on our website, it would be about $375. And the offer for you today is $97. And this is really, I think, the ideal way to get started with the Emotion Code, because you get to watch and you get to listen and you get to read, and you've got the magnet and you've got everything that you need to really become proficient at this. Now, we also have a 100% money back guarantee. So if for any reason you decide, oh, this just isn't for you, you can send us back the physical items within 30 days, and then we just give you back your money. But you get to keep the ebook and the audio downloads as our gift to you.
This is such a powerful thing, everybody. You can simply click on the special offer button that is on this page, and it will take you right there. Truly, this is so powerful. And don't be fooled by how simple it seems. Is that a fair assessment of how to look at it? I think sometimes people want things or think they need to be hard.
It's so funny. I have to tell you, you're so right. About every other seminar that I teach, someone will come up to me and they'll say, Dr. Nelson, this just seems just too simple. And my response is always the same. I always say, well, I could make it more difficult for you if you'd like. But it is so simple. It doesn't need to be hard.
And that's why we're here. We're talking about effortless manifestation. This is exactly the point. So, you know, this stuff, I mean, I've experienced it on calls with you where I literally feel an instant lift of these emotions. What are some of the things that, you know, that's my personal experience. Mm-hmm. What are some of the things you would say most people, you know, when they start working with this, they could expect to start to experience right away, as opposed to over time, we know some of the profound changes.
Well, you know, one of the most common problems that we all suffer from is pain. Mm. And the biggest underlying reason for that pain is emotional baggage. And the Emotion Code makes it very simple to find out if there's a trapped emotion that is behind the pain that you're feeling. And when that emotion is released, it's not unusual at all within a matter of minutes for people to feel dramatically better as far as their pain goes. In fact, I got an email the other night from a lady who said that her husband was about a 9 on a 0 to 10 scale with his knee pain. It was killing him. And he asked her to check him to see if he had a trapped emotion. And he did. She released a trapped emotion that was having, that was creating this problem. And his knee pain went to a one instantly. And
wow.
That's not unusual at all. Yeah, she was crying and, you know, telling me this. So, yes, it's simple, but it also happens to be true. And I've dedicated my life to this, to getting this message out to the world. And like I said, you know, I'd love to take credit for it, but it just came through me. It really came from up above. And so this is your chance to do something for yourself that may just make the difference for you. If you've got a heart wall, you need to get rid of that heart wall, or basically you're going to be living your life in a bunker. That's what it's like. It's like living in a bunker, because you know, when the bombs are falling, it's great to be in a bunker, but when the bombs stop falling, if you're still living the rest of your life in a bunker, that's what was happening with my wife. Her heart was basically in a bunker for the rest of her life. And I mean, if you're single, if you are trying to find love, I'm telling you, you have got to get rid of your heart wall, because then love will find you in most cases. It's really amazing how it works. And it isn't something that takes a lot of effort. It's just something that it just seems to happen. And I can tell you one more story if you want.
Yeah, please. That would be great.
Okay. This is one of my favorite stories that illustrates this so well. There was a nurse who came to me when I was in practice, and shortly after I discovered this about the heart wall. And she came into me because she had neck pain, and she'd seen a couple of other doctors for it, and they weren't able to help her. So she came in to see me. And as I was talking with her, she told me that she was basically celibate. She hadn't dated in 8 years, and she wasn't ever going to date again. She was going to be single the rest of her life, and she was dead serious. And she was an attractive woman. And I said, well, what happened to you? And she said that 8 years before, she was really in love with this guy, and he dumped her and broke her heart. And that was it. She'd sworn off dating or having any kind of relationship. Well, as you might imagine, the emotions of that event, that breakup, were so powerful that they actually got stuck in her body. And she formed a heart wall at that time because her heart was breaking. And so she had this heart wall, three emotions making up that heart wall. And it took me probably, I don't know, maybe 5, 6, 8 minutes to release those emotions. And suddenly her neck pain was gone. And she was amazed, but neck pain and pain in the upper shoulders and stiffness and so on up in that area of the body is very common when you have a heart wall, see? And a lot of people have that. Well, as massage therapists all know, right? Well, anyway, so she left the office feeling better, and I didn't see her again for 3 months. And when she came back into the office, I said, hey, how are you? I remember this like it was yesterday. She said, I'm great. You know, my neck pain's been fine. It was gone, you know, right then, and never came back. But she said, you cleared that heart wall for me, and that really works. Because she said, a couple of weeks after I was here last, I found out my childhood sweetheart has been living right around the corner from me, and for almost 8 years. And she said, we're dating now, and we're in love, and I think he's going to ask me to marry him. You know, talk about a transformation, right?
Right.
Yeah.
That was fast.
Yeah, so fast. And that's how powerful this is. And you know, I'll tell you something else. I had an experience once where I was working on someone, and I was sitting across from this woman and working on her and releasing her heart wall. She was 43 years old. She'd never been married and wanted to be married. She had a goal to be married within the following year. And I was working on her, and I handed her a magnet. And so she was released. I would find the emotions, and she would release them by passing the magnet from her forehead to the back of her neck. And there were 7 or 8 emotions making up her heart wall. So we sat there for about a half an hour. And when the last emotion was cleared, I had this experience that was so profound. It was like a stone had suddenly been rolled away from her heart. And suddenly I was just instantly bathed with this incredible feeling. It was coming out of her core. It was like her heart, the light of her heart was suddenly shining, and I was in the beam of it. And it was just the most incredible feeling that I had. And she didn't notice it. She didn't feel it. But I told her what I was feeling. It was kind of like if you have a long, cold winter and you walk outside and the sun's shining for the first time and you throw your head back and you just kind of go, oh, that feels so great. That's what this felt like. It was amazing. And I told her what I was feeling. And I said, your heart is unlocked. And I said, now that wall is taken down. And that pure essence of who you really are is now radiating out from your heart and filling the immensity of space. And I said, now the things that you really want are going to start being attracted into your life automatically. And as I was saying those words, she happened to be Orthodox Jew. And I had I was back in New York at this convention thing where I met her. And as I was saying those words to her, this Orthodox Jewish doctor, who was absolutely on the 0 to 10 handsome scale, this guy was like a 12. He walks right by me like I'm not even there. He walks right up to her like a moth to the flame and strikes up this conversation. And I remember thinking, wow, this stuff really works fast.
That's awesome. That's very cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just love spending time with you. You've got such great energy and such belief in what you're doing, and I also have such belief in what you're doing that makes it easy. But we've run out of time here, but I would love to push you for just a little bit extra, like one final gem of, you know, Dr. Braden brilliance that you could send us off with today.
Well, I'll tell you, I believe that the world is in a tremendous state of transformation right now, and a lot of the old constructs and the old ideas and the old fixed ways of doing things are gradually falling away. And this work is part of that, you see, because when someone steps out of their old skin and they step out of all those old emotions that have been affecting their lives and creating their self-sabotage and their diseases and all kinds of problems for them, when they step out of that old skin, they step into a new kind of a being. They step into they step back into the person that God intended them to become from the beginning, and they become much better instruments for God to be able to do his work and to be instruments for him in this world. And they're able to feel love. I mean, we've had people come back who have told us that for the first time in their lives, after having their heart wall removed, they can feel God's love for them. And part of my message is that God is real and that he loves us and that this is part of it. You see, this emotion code, he's given us this way to get rid of our emotional baggage. And as we do that, we not only are elevating ourselves and our loved ones, we're also elevating the whole planet. And I'll tell you something. Here's what I believe. I believe that every emotion that's released, and especially every heart wall that is taken down, loosens the grip of darkness on this world. And the day is going to come when there will be no more darkness in this world, when this world will be filled with nothing but light. And this is part of how we get there. One person at a time. One trapped emotion at a time, one heart wall at a time, but gradually, gradually, we are going to get there. And this is part of that. And that's why this is coming into the world now at this time when we really need it. That's my two bits for you.
Perfect. Well, I love it. It's the perfect way to end this. I agree. We're in the midst of a huge and positive transformation. I'm excited. All of you that listen, you are all absolutely extraordinary, and I am blessed to be able to spend time with you. Dr. Brad, you are just fantastic. I am blessed to be able to spend time with you, and I can't wait till we do this again.
Absolutely, Kristen. Anytime.
All right. Well, thank you all so much, and I'll talk to you all soon. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.